Now that we've recorded some groups, let's take a look at our group list. To get into the group list, simply hit the group key from Live. Inside of the group list, we see a list of all of our groups, the text label we gave it when we created, a note field if you'd like, and the channels that have been recorded into the groups in the order in which they were selected. Group order becomes very important later on when we start talking about effects. You'll notice right off the bat that these channels inside of this group have an M in them. M is a mark value. It's not an intensity that truly exists, but it's not quite zero either. When we record groups, we have the ability to record their intensity with them as we build. To jump back into Live for a second, I'll show you exactly how this works. When we first created our groups, we selected a channel and just recorded the group. We didn't give it an intensity. This is perfectly fine if we want to just use our groups for selection, but it can become very useful to have groups with intensity built in. To record a group with intensity, we select our channels, one, channel, four, through, and give it some intensity. Now we record the group we want. I'll do this in the Direct Select dock, record Direct Select, and tap the one we want. And I'm just going to call this Specials 2. Once we've recorded this group, if we go back into the group list, we can take a look at the difference between the two groups. Specials 1 simply has the mark information for intensity. Specials 2 holds a full value. This will come into play later on, but is no means required. It's just the way you want to program. If you want to have intensity in there, great. If not, you've got a perfectly fine selector.